Doris Karren Burton was born 16th of March, 1932 in Vernal, Utah. She died at the age of 83, 17th of June, 2015 in Vernal, Utah. She's buried at Rock Point Cemetery in Mesa, Uintah County, Utah. Doris was an advocate for making sure that history was wrote down. She worked with the sheriff's office recording information. She did history of the Blue Mountains and Uintah County. She was born in Vernal and then was taken at 6 weeks old to a little dirt roof log cabin home that had dirt floors. For the winter, they had come back into Vernal. We would like to give credit to Doris and also Kerry Ross Boren for all of the wonderful history that they've preserved. The history we would like to present is that of Josie Martha Bassett. They called her Josie Bassett. She was from Jansen in her elderly years. She was born in Arkansas at the age of four. She came to Browns Park, where her family settled. Her parents had five children. Browns Park is on the north side of the Green River. Josie worked hard when she was young, getting ready for womanhood. She was extremely beautiful. She learned to ride horses at the age of four. By age eight, she had mastered roping and riding horses. These Brown Park maps are by Kerry Ross Boren. Josie was a lovely young lady who was sent to refinement school in two different areas by her father with her sister Anne. She is known to be able to ride with the Butch Cassidy, and yes, she did. She had an affair with Butch Cassidy. Here are original pictures from FWC Hathenbrook files in which it shows Josie with them. Josie knew the country. She was able to ride with the best, and she did. Josie married Jim McKnight in Green River, Wyoming. He later died. They had two sons, Crawford McKnight and Herbert Chick McKnight. They had eight grandchildren, 17 grandchildren, and three great-grandchildren. Josie continued to ranch in Cub Creek, where she raised her boys. Later on, one moved to Jansen and the other one moved to Tonopah, Nevada. Josie continued ranching. She grew gardens, chopped wood, and maintained her home. She was able to share with neighbors the produce, and Josie was generous. It is known that she one winter put a homeless family into her home, and she stayed in a dugout through that winter that they might have a warm place to be. Josie married Ben Morris in 1914 in Vernal, and they were later divorced. She was a colorful old lady of the West. She lived alone, 14 miles away from Jansen and 4 miles from the nearest. She continued gardening and ranching. During the Depression, she was known to have been able to help her son, who lived in Jansen, be Crawford McKnight, her son, and his family came and lived with her during part of the Depression so that she could assist them in keeping fed and taken care of. She had a very nice garden. She bottled and canned fruit and vegetables and preserved her own means for winter time. Josie stands out as one of the most colorful characters in Uintah County's colorful past. She was a unique blend of sweet, generous, lovable white-haired lady who occasionally rustled cows, poached deers, and bootlegged whiskey. She loved growing roses and attending to her yard. She was never free from rumors. Josie ran her own relief agency. She was known to have taken in strays and helped people along their way when they were ranching and going through her area. She'd make them breakfast, coffee, and hot biscuits and gravy. She had a spare room in which she allowed people to rest. Josie homesteaded this land for some time. Then she was able to make a purchase of a small fee to make the homestead legally hers. She needed some cash, and unfortunately, there was a misunderstanding and she lost some of her land. She did, however, retain her cabin and a few acres on a separate adjoining property. There she lived for nearly 20 more years. She had at the age of 89, while alone in her cabin, she fell and broke her hip. And that experience was terrible agony before she was found. This ended her days on the homestead. Josie was buried at the Bassett Cemetery in Brown Park.